our sun salutation flow that we're going to do for you today. So this is just a nice short video just for you to follow, just with the sun salutation basics. If you ever just want a quick flow just to follow when you've got a short space of time, just to build a little bit of heat, we're going to talk you through the different variations and just have a go at flowing through our basic sun salutations. So we're going to start in Tadasana, mountain pose. Stood up. Okay. So if you want to come forward to the front of your mat, okay, the feet are going to ground down, hands down by your sides, palms open, roll the shoulders down the back, and imagine there's a strain coming from the crown of your head all the way up. So in our mountain pose, we want strong but soft at exactly the same time. So we're rooting down through the ground of the feet, through the bottom of the feet. Shoulders are nice and soft, head is nice and tall. So pick all 10 toes up off the floor, spread them nice and wide, and peel them all the way back down again. And to start with, we're just going to shift the weight onto one foot and then onto the other. So just getting a feel for the way that the weight travels through the body. The way the natural rhythm of the body is moving. Just paying attention to all the different movements that you can feel. So just grounding down. And allowing yourself to find a moment of stillness. So it's not going to be completely still when you're in mountain pose. You're going to feel all the different tiny little movements that are happening within the body at exactly the same time while you're stood here. All the different things, all the different parts of the body that have to stop you from falling down onto the floor, that keep you nice and tall. So allow yourself a few moments just to find some awareness. Big inhale through the nose and exhale through the mouth. And again, inhale through the nose, but draw the shoulders all the way up towards the ears. Exhale round down the back through the mouth. Once more, inhale, shoulders all the way up. And exhale, roll them down the back, out through the mouth. Give yourself a few moments of stillness, just to tune in with the body, how the body's feeling today. And then start to create those tiny little movements back into the body. So left and right, putting all the weight onto the toes, onto the heels, shifting the weight forward and backwards, side to side. And then going to a neutral position, feet ground down. Start to wiggle the shoulders, wake them up, turn the palms out. Big inhale, arms come all the way towards the ceiling. Exhale, heart center. Inhale, arms come all the way back up. Exhale, heart center. Inhale, come all the way back up. Make it as mindful as you can, really stretching all the way out towards the fingertips. And exhale, heart center. Plug the thumbs in towards the chest. Really feel the hands pushing towards each other. Shoulders still nice and soft. Big inhale. And exhale. Inhale, arms are going to come up. Again, all the way up towards the ceiling. And on exhale, bend the knees, nice soft bend, fold from the hips, come all the way down onto the mat. Good. Plant the hands down. Good. So always having a little tiny micro bend in the knees, and then taking it a lot deeper if you feel quite tight. You can bring the hands onto a block. You can rest the hands on the shins. And just sway the body from side to side. Any gentle movements. And you're going to inhale and peel. You're going to roll all the way, vertebrae by vertebrae, all the way up Making the head the last thing to reach the top. Arms come up as well. Exhale, heart center. Inhale, arms up. Circle all the way up. Exhale, forward fold. Uttanasana. Or over the legs. Again, nice soft bend. Sway the body side to side. Hug the core into center. Pull the belly button in. And inhale, peel the body all the way up off the floor. Head's the last thing, arms come up. Exhale, heart center. And do that one more time. Inhale, arms come all the way back up. Exhale, forward fold. Again, swaying the body. Maybe you can start to really bend one knee and lengthen out the other. So we're stretching out the hamstrings, the calf, having a nice soothing forward fold. Big deep breath in, inhale, look forward, and exhale, forward fold. Now when you're in time, I want you to step back into tabletop. Okay, so in our tabletop, toes are untucked. Make sure the hands are directly below the shoulders and the knees directly below the hips. We want a really nice, spacious tabletop. Fingers nice and spread, and nice and wide. So nice neutral spine to start with. And then we're gonna do some cat-cow. So inhale, dip the belly, lift the tailbone and the heart, look forward. Exhale, round the spine, tuck the chin and the tailbone down. Inhale, come back up. Exhale. Exhale, round the spine. Inhale, back up. Exhale, round the spine. And just stay here for two breaths. Really trying to breathe into the different parts of the spine whilst you're in this pose. Try to find that really nice arch. So especially in the morning, you might feel it a little bit more in different parts of the back. And then inhale, come back up. And we're gonna do the same again. Stay here for two breaths, really arching that tailbone up, looking forward. And then just make your way into a neutral spine. Now we're going to come into downward facing dog. So I want you to tuck the toes to start with, lift the knees off the floor, and you're going to start to bring the hips up, send the shoulders all the way towards the thighs. Okay, so we're going to have a nice bent knee downward dog to start with, so really deep bend in the knees. And start to pedal out the feet. So you're pushing into the mat with the hands coming out of the shoulders. Always having this really nice lift all the way from the hands up towards the hips. This nice line that comes all the way up nice and tall. So pedaling out the feet, stretching out the back of the calf, the hamstrings, sending the heels down one at a time. And then when you feel ready to, just start to sink the heels down onto the mat. So they don't have to touch the mat, you just want that idea of really sending the heels towards the mat. So really nice line, all the way up, all the way down. Take a deep breath in through the nose. Exhale through the mat. Inhale through the nose. Exhale through the mat. Bring the two big toes together. Take a nice big inhale, look forward in between the hands and take tiny little baby steps all the way towards the hands. Hang it over the legs. Big breath out. Inhale to a flat back. And exhale, forward fold. Inhale, roll the body all the way up, arms come up. Exhale, heart center. Shoulders soft. Inhale, rise all the way back up. Exhale, Uttanasana, forward fold. And hands down. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, release down. Plant the hands. You're going to make your way into plank. So step back one foot and then the other. So crown of the head sets forward, lifts forward. Good. And the heels push all the way back. Now you can drop the knees here, a little bit too much. Okay.
And then start to bend the knees lower down onto the mat. Good. Elbow squeeze in, release the feet down. Good. Hands below the shoulders, inhale into a tiny little cobra. So elbows stay bent, shoulders rolled back. And then exhale, tuck the toes, make your way into downward facing dog. Nice big inhale. Exhale, walk the feet slowly towards the hands. Inhale to a flat back. And exhale, forward fold. Inhale, roll the arms, roll the back all the way up. Come all the way up to standing, circle the arms up. Look up towards the hands if you want to. Exhale, heart center. Inhale, arms up. And exhale, forward fold. Plant the hands down, inhale, flat back. You can bring the hands to the shins if you find that a little bit easier. Exhale, forward fold. Hands planted, step back one at a time back into your plank. Now we're gonna drop the knees, we're gonna drop the chest, keep the toes tucked, and we're gonna drop the chin looking forward. Good. And then slide up into your cobra, shoulders roll back, elbows still bent, good. Tuck the toes, exhale, downward dog. Big breath in through the nose. And exhale. In through the nose. And exhale through the mouth. So giving yourself as much time as you need in your downward dog, allowing to really breathe in the pose, let it all come out, come back to your downward dog, your resting pose. Two big toes together. Take a nice big inhale. And take a big step up towards the hands. Exhale, fold over the legs. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, release down. Inhale, reverse swan dive this time. Look forward, arms circle, come all the way up. And exhale, heart center. Give yourself a breath here, ground down through the feet, roll the shoulders back. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, forward fold. Plant the hands, look forward, inhale. Exhale, Uttanasana. Hands planted, step back into your plank. Knees down, lower chaturanga down onto the mat. Inhale, upward facing dog or cobra. So upward facing dog, arms straight, shoulders stay nice, and pull back away from the ears. Thighs off the floor, tops of the feet ground down. Roll over the toes, exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale through the nose, exhale through the mouth. Give yourself one more big breath here. And we're going to go ahead and inhale, bring the right leg all the way up towards the ceiling. Keep the hips nice and square just to start with. Good. Squeeze them towards each other, feet nice and flexed. Good. Big breath in. And exhale. Another breath in, big inhale, and on your exhale, I want you to float forward and drop the foot in between the hands, good? Drop the back knee, and come up into a low lunge. So hands stay down, look forward, lengthen, big inhale. And on an exhale, step that right foot back to meet the left, come back into your plank. Again, drop the knees, lower on to the mat. Inhale, up dog or cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, left leg lift all the way up again, keeping the hips nice and squared. Exhale, float forward, drop the foot in between the hands. Drop the back knee down. And always making sure that the knee is no further than the ankle. Hands are down either side. Inhale, lengthen through the crown of the head, nice and tall. Exhale, step the foot back to meet the right. Good. Knees up or down. Hug the elbows in, lower chaturanga. Inhale, up dog or cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Big breath in, big inhale. And exhale through the mouth. And inhale through the nose. And exhale through the mouth. Big inhale, two big toes together, bend the knees. Take a step or little baby steps up towards the mat. And exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, Uttanasana. Plant the hands. And roll nice and slowly, come all the way up. Arms come up. Exhale, heart center. And take a breath. Big inhale through the nose. And exhale through the mouth. Bend the knees, bring the hands behind you. Two big toes together, heels slightly apart. Good. Hands behind. Bend down. Stroke the floor with the fingertips, rise up into chair, Utkatasana. So the weight of the weight comes into the back of the heels, chest lifts, palms facing each other. Good. The inhale, exhale, forward fold. And the hands down. Good. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Step back into your plank. Knees up or down, lower, chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog or cobra. Exhale, downward dog. Inhale, right leg lifts up. Feel free to open up the hip if you want to. So we're going to bend the knee, open up the hip as though this right hip is stacking on top of the left. This foot nice and flexed. Yes. Straighten the leg back out, big inhale. Exhale, float forward, drop the foot in between the hands. Drop the heel of the back foot, keep the knee lifted. And we're going to rise up, warrior one. So hips nice and squared. Inhale, rise up. Palms facing each other, shoulders roll back. Opening up the chest, finding a nice warrior. Drop the heel of the back foot. Good. Another big inhale. Exhale, fold down, plant the hands. Step the right foot back to meet the left. Knees up or down. Lower, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog or cobra. And exhale, downward dog. Inhale, left leg lifts. Rise all the way up, open up the hip, bend the knee, flex the foot. Good, really nice and wide. Shoulders stay nice and squared. Inhale, straighten the leg out. And exhale, float forward, drop the foot in between the hands, drop the heel of the back foot. Inhale, rise up, warrior one. Finding that really nice, strong warrior. You can make it as much of a back bend as you want to. Big inhale, exhale, forward fold. Good. Step the back foot forward to meet the front, folding over the legs. Inhale, halfway lift. And exhale. Inhale, forward, fold. Inhale, reverse swan dive, rise all the way up. Hands come up. And exhale, heart center. Inhale, arms rise up. Exhale, forward fold, through heart center, fold over the legs. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Step back into the plank, gonna be our last vinyasa. Knees up or down, lower onto the mat. Inhale, up dog or cobra. And exhale, child's pose. So the hips come back towards the feet, our resting pose. Hands come down, lengthening all the way out. Good. Resting the forehead down onto the mat. So giving yourself time to just release that all the breath go. Inhale through the nose. So inhale, start to walk the hands towards you, arms come up, and exhale, heart center. And plant the hands down, make your way onto the mat, just seated with the legs out in front of you, hands come down, inhale, lengthen, and exhale, walk the fingertips, gaze over the toes, keep the
spine nice and long, nice and tall. Just resting the hands wherever they lie once you get to a point where you feel like it's a bit of a no-go. Just release the neck down so you're not putting any tension on the back of the neck and allow yourself just to rest here for a few moments in a nice forward fold. Inhale, lengthen. And exhale, fold. Inhale to lengthen. And exhale, forward fold. Slowly starting to walk the hands back up. And lower down onto the mat. Lower the whole body. Comes all the way down. Arms down by the sides, palms facing up. And just relax the feet, relax the legs. If you make any movements, just to find a nice comfortable spot to lie. Resting the head from side to side until you find a nice spot for it to lie. We're closing the eyes, focusing on the breath, focusing on the inhales through the nose. And the exhales through the mouth. So you can spend as long as you like here in your Shavasana. It's completely up to you depending on how much time you have. So 5 minutes or 20 minutes, as long as you want to. Namaste.